Hi everyone, it's Rhiannon here. Happy New Year, and I hope you're all ready to hear about another excellent book. So the book I want to talk about today is The Peculiar Pegs of Riddling Woods by Samuel J. Halpin and illustrated by Hannah Peck. This book is a 9 to 12 adventure and it's so enjoyable and so fun. I'd highly recommend picking it up. I'd really recommend it for fans of Nevermore by Jessica Townsend or A Place Called Perfect by Helena Duggan. So The Peculiar Pegs of Riddling Woods is about a girl called Poppy who goes to live with her grandma in a town called Suds after her mother passes away and her dad has to go on a work trip. And there's something a little bit strange about the town of Suds. Her grandma always has to keep her sugar lumps covered at all times, and you have to keep the window ledges full of cobwebs, and Poppy just sort of goes along with it, but never really asking why. And then one day Poppy finds this mysterious book that has nothing in it but a really strange silky cover, and she starts talking to a boy called Erasmus Tall, and then they go on an adventure together and try and work out the secrets of the town of Suds. It's a really beautiful, simple adventure story that just kind of makes you feel like a child again when you read it. The adventure as well is so fun. I love, you know, big towns with mysteries in them, and you can kind of half work it out as you go along, which is always one of my very favourite things to do. One of my other favourite things about this book are Hannah Peck's illustrations. I think they're absolutely lovely, very simple, you can see from the cover, and of course it has these lovely sprayed edges, which is always nice. My favourite character, I think, would have to be Poppy's grandma. She is the best, and I want her to be my grandma. She's so funny and quirky and very emotional, very real. She was the mother of Poppy's mum, so she kind of has a strained relationship with Poppy's dad, and that's presented, I think, very well. One of my favourite things about this book is Erasmus. Erasmus has Asperger's, and it's portrayed in a very sensitive way, and Poppy, the main character, doesn't really understand Erasmus at first, but she slowly gets to know him and understands what he needs from her and how he sees the world. And it's handled in a really lovely way, and I think it's going to be a really good book for kids to understand more about people with Asperger's, and also for kids with Asperger's to read it and see themselves represented in the book. The atmosphere is slightly spooky, but very exciting, never too scary. I'd say definitely 8 or 9 to about 12 or 13, this would be perfect for. Or if you're a big kid like me, it's also just a perfect example of a really enjoyable 9 to 12 book, and how you can teach kids important things whilst also entertaining them. If you're looking for a good book to read to your kids at night, or just a good book for you, I'd really recommend it. I think everyone should read more 9 to 12 books because they are just incredible. I mean, I've said this before, but I think they are just really enjoyable. It does remind you of what it's like to be a child and what it's like to be wrapped up in an adventure. And I can only hope that this is the start of more, because I love the world that Halpin creates and I can't wait to go back and see what Poppy gets up to. Thanks for watching, everyone. Let me know if you've read it or if you've read any books similar to it. I'm always looking for recommendations, so you can let me know in the comments. Have a lovely day!